project's been incredibly fun because it circles around antiques, which I absolutely love. There's something about finding a piece, and the best part is thinking, what has it seen over all the years? That just makes my heart go warm. The antique yard we go to is Charles Phillips Antiques, and there is actually a Charles Phillips. Obviously, he deals in antiques every day. He's a major buyer of them all over the world. I thought, what a perfect person to approach to ask about the antiques that we have with the Ford House and to be able to understand more about them. The year that they came from, the wood species that they're made out of, what purpose they served, and he was very helpful. It was a really great time. All right, I should have worn my raincoat. I didn't even take a coat. We're looking for interior doors and exterior doors to use in the restoration. And rather than buying new, if we could find one that could be repurposed, that would just be the ultimate. And definitely for the interior doors, we have certainly found some.
See, there is something cute about that little arch though.
Yeah, this is pretty. I mean, it's not exact match to your house, but that is.
Yeah, that is. Yeah, you just go from building to building, and he sells everything from doors and shutters to, I picked up a couple of milk buckets this morning. You name it, he has it in furniture. And the unique thing about Charles Phillips Antique Yard is it's not just antiques for sale. He also repurposes some of them himself. Because this house is in the Oakleigh Garden District, we wanted to meet someone that was an authority on the history of this area. And so we met Lauren of the Oakleigh Garden Historical Society, who actually works out of the Oakleigh House.
My name is Lauren Vanderbail, and I work here in the neighborhood for the Historic Mobile Preservation Society as a consultant. The neighborhood in the early colonial period was outside the city limits. However, the city grew very quickly. And this map from the 1890s shows Rapier just being carved out. During the Civil War, even earlier, the first line of defense for the city actually ran right along where Rapier is today. So the trenches and where the camps were along this area.
In our short time here in Oakleigh, one of the things that's just unbelievable to us, we've always heard the term Southern hospitality. From the first day standing on our porch and meeting the neighbors and them inviting us into their homes and attending church with them and whatever it is they've been doing, football parties, incredible hospitality.
There is a certain spirit about this neighborhood. It's one of the oldest historic districts in the city, so there's a lot of loyalty to it. There's a lot of pride that goes into this neighborhood and the owners and those who've invested here. There is just this great spirit of hospitality and generosity here.
She also told us about where the name Rapier Avenue came from, which was actually a family name, and Mr. Rapier and his family lived on the end of the street. And we're gonna have to do more research on who Mr. Rapier is to have a street named after him. I gotta figure out how to do that. Dualdy Avenue, it's got a ring. So the house is called the Morgan Ford House from the previous owners. I thought that it was totally appropriate that I should buy a Ford pickup from days gone by as well. And so I managed to find myself a 1948 Ford, and it's even the same trim color as the house, Bellingrath green. And I was pretty excited to receive that.
Okay, now I'm happier than a dead pig in sunshine.
Coming up next on Southern Romance.
The daughter that was born in this home in 1923 actually came to my tea party.